Judith Kirkness here with another Minotaur Minute. In my last video, I talked about retail barcodes, the G1012s, or they used to be called UPC codes. Those are what are used at retail to scan and make sure you've got the right item and they charge you the right price at a grocery store. Then I talked about G1014s, the classic barcode on most cases that simply tells you what item it is. Obviously, that's pretty important. You've got to make sure you ship your customer the right item. But neither of those barcodes can help you with traceability. A lot of companies in the food industry are still using some form of human-readable, laser-jet-printed information about what lot it is, where it goes across the line, and inkjets, you know, today's lot number and such encoded in what we call human-readable. So human-readable is great for anybody looking at the box and wanting to find out information. But it doesn't help us with scanning because it's not encoded into the barcode. In order to have traceability and lot numbers or serial number traceability and pick it up with a scanner, it has to be encoded into the barcode. So the kind of barcode, my favorite barcode, is the code 128 barcode, also known as the GS1-128. It's a kind of barcode that's a segmented barcode, which means that it contains multiple pieces of information, but they can grab that in a single scan. So let me show an example of that. Here's a box that's from the grocery store, but it's for grapes. And you can see that this code here, this very long one, is a code 128 barcode. It contains multiple pieces of information, and in a single scan, all those pieces can be read. Now, it also contains all the information, human readable, so somebody without a scanner can still get the same information. But if you want to scan for fast movement and actual tracking of lots, then you need one of these great barcodes. And so in this one, following the Produce Traceability Initiative suggestions, it has three segments. There's actually 99 possible segments that could be in this barcode. So it's important to note that just because you have a code 128 barcode doesn't mean you have one that is going to be sufficient for traceability. It's got to have useful segments that you can use as a lot number or serial number in your computer system. And you've also got to have a computer system that can handle those segments. So in this one, it's got three segments. An O1, which is a G1014. So the same information that's contained in that G1014 barcode that's on the outside of many cases, pre-printed for that particular item, is also contained in the code 128. Then you've got two other segments in this case. You've got a date, a 13 segment, and a 10. And I can tell those different segments because there's little brackets around the different numbers, 01, 13, 10. Makes it a lot easier to read the barcode. Now, there doesn't have to be brackets. The important thing is that the information that's encoded into that barcode is often actually printed underneath the barcode in human readable text, so you can decipher if you know where to go. So I suggest that you just go to Wikipedia, type in code 128 or GS1-128 barcode application identifiers. That's the name for the little segments that are in front of the information and tell you what the information is in a barcode. So an 01 segment is that G1014. 13 segment is a date, probably date of production or possibly date of packaging. Then there's the 10. 10 is a lot number, so a very valuable segment. In the meat industry, they use some different segments in the code 128. Let me grab a meat box. So in this meat box here, they've actually not got the brackets underneath. So it's like one long, long number. So it makes it a little bit harder for you to decipher, but once you get the hang of this, then it's going to be pretty easy for you to go through your warehouse and look at all the different barcodes and see what you've actually got to work with if you started scanning. So in this barcode, they've got the 01, got to have your item code, that's for sure. Then they've also got a weight field and a serial number instead of a lot number. Now, why would they do that? Because in the meat industry, a lot of the cases that they ship are actually, each one of them is serial numbered and has unique weight, and they charge the customer by dollar per pound or dollar per kilo, so they have to know how much this particular case weighs. So then there's also a date field in there, usually the date of packaging or production. So now you've got 4 different fields that are in this one barcode. There can actually be more fields. I'm starting to see country of origin field on some of the meat products. So the important thing to remember is that there's all these fields, but it's still, again, a barcode is only useful if you can do something with it. So you need a software program that's able to parse out that barcode into the segments, put them into the appropriate fields, and then help you do something with it, whether it be report on it, whether it be just store the information, should there be a recall. Any of those things make the barcode useful and give you enough information for traceability. So I highly recommend the Code 128 barcodes if you're in the food industry. If you're not there yet, it's probably where you're ultimately going to want to go, because it not only allows you to manage with scanning in your own warehouse and make sure you know what lot went to what customer, but it allows the next person down the supply chain, your customer, to also scan and use that same information. So if you ended up recalling something that was produced on a given day, well, if your customer had this kind of barcode and they could scan this kind of barcode, they could determine if they have any of those with that segment of that date to be able to recall it themselves. So it's not just about you, it's about everybody along the supply chain. But we have to start with the manufacturers, because those are the ones that are putting the barcodes on the products as soon as they're made. So I suggest that even if you are doing a G1014, which is a standard case code, have I got the right item? I highly recommend you start exploring getting code 128s on those products as well. Thanks so much. Join me next time for another Minotaur Minute.